Hello, my name is Elia, I'm a project officer.
And my name is Sophie, I am also a project officer.
In this tutorial, we would like to show you how to apply for a core or a small project. Before you watch this tutorial, please make sure you submitted your project idea form, or PIF. As a reminder, you get access to the program's electronic data exchange system called Bamos Plus after the submission of your PIF, and the appointing document. If you have not done so yet, please watch the tutorial How to Apply Preparatory Phase.
Login. As soon as we have created your Bamos Plus user account, you will receive an email from noreply@bamos.eu with the subject BA Plus User Activation. Please make sure that this email address is whitelisted in the spam filters of your organization's mail server. The activation email contains a link, which allows you to define a password for your account. Your username is the email address that you have indicated when applying for your account. In case you forget your password, please use the Forgot Password option at the login page with the internet address baplus.bamos.eu.
Users in Bamos Plus and their rights. There are three types of users in Bamos Plus: users with reading, writing, and submitting rights, users with reading and writing rights, and users with reading rights only. Each user type has specific roles assigned and can perform different actions in the system. 1. Users with reading, writing, submitting rights, and initial users. The initial user of your project is the very first user in Bamos Plus. In the appointing document, you have already indicated the name of this person, who must be an employee of the lead applicant's organization authorized to represent the organization in the project. This person will be the first and only one to receive access to Bamos Plus from the Managing Authority Joint Secretariat.
Is there any difference between the initial user and other users with reading, writing, submitting rights?
Every initial user is also a user with reading, writing, and submitting rights. The difference from other users with the same rights is that it is the first user who was appointed and granted access to Bamos Plus. This is also the first user who can start creating new accounts for other users in your project. After that, any user with reading, writing, submitting rights is able to create further accounts. To avoid any confusion, we will refer to both the initial user and the other users with the same rights as users with reading, writing, and submitting rights.
What are the specific roles of this type of user?
These users can read and edit any section of their project in Bamos Plus, submit data and files to the Managing Authority Joint Secretariat via the system, they are the only users who can do so, and create further accounts for any type of user.
When creating users with reading, writing, and submitting rights, make sure they comply with the following conditions. Any user of this type must be an employee of the lead applicant's organization authorized to represent the project. He or she must fill out and sign an appointing document. In comparison to the initial user, however, these documents will not be submitted to the secretariat, but must be filed at the lead partner organization.
2. Users with reading and writing rights. Who should receive accounts with such rights?
You can create these types of accounts, for example, for project partners actively involved in the development of the project or for external experts supporting you in the process. These are users whom you closely cooperate with, but they do not legally represent the lead applicant organization in the project, and therefore they cannot have the right to submit any data to us via the system.
3. Users with reading rights only. Who should receive accounts with such rights?
Organizations that might be interested in the progress you are making in the project preparation without being actively involved in writing the application.
Application form. Now let's have a look at the application form. You can see on the screen that the application form includes the following tabs. 1. Project summary. 2. Partnership. 3. Relevance. 4. Management. 5. Work plan. 6. Indicators. 7. Budget. And 8. Submission and PDF.
Before we start, you will note that there are white and light gray fields. You need to fill in the white ones and the gray ones will be filled automatically. You will also see that there is guidance for each of the fields. Please read the guidance before you start writing. We recommend following the order of the sections, as some features in the following sections will only be available if the previous ones are complete. Before you go to the following section, do not forget to save what you have done.
The first section, Project Summary, includes the name of your project, full and short versions, the program objective within which you are applying, the duration of your project, its summary, and the summary of your partnership. You need to fill in at least the project full name, the short name, and the program objective before you can go to Section 2, Partnership.
In Section 2, Partnership, you will insert the data of each project partner and associated organization. You will also need to select the type of organization and describe its role in the project. Please note that the first project partner is the lead partner.
In Section 3, Relevance, you will need to provide the context and challenge of your project, its transnational value, your target groups and their needs, and your project objective. For small projects, you will also need to indicate the specific aims. You will also need to indicate whether your project contributes to the EU strategy for the Baltic Sea region or any other strategic document, and to indicate whether it is based on a seed money project. This is also the section where you will need to demonstrate how you use the outcomes of other projects.
In Section 4, Management, you will need to confirm compliance with the rules related to project management, financial management and control, as well as communication. You only need to tick the boxes, and if relevant, you can add text. At the beginning of this section, you will also need to indicate the approximate budget. Together with the budget of Section 5, Work Plan, it needs to add up to 100%.
In Section 5, Work Plan, you will see 3 work packages if you develop a core project and 1 work package if you develop a small project. Below, you can see an overview of the work packages and an overview of outputs and deliverables, but these graphs will only appear once you entered the information related to the activities that you will implement. Once you are in a given work package, you will need to select the work package leader, the work package budget, and the number of pilots if you plan any. As a reminder, pilots are compulsory in the second work package of core projects. They are not compulsory for small projects. In the work plan, you will also need to explain how you plan to reach out and to engage the target groups you selected in Section 3 Relevance. You will be able to enter a maximum of 5 groups of activities per work package. In each group of activities you create, you will see new fields appearing.
Section 6, Indicators, will only appear once Section Work Plan is complete. You will explain how the planned project contributes to the output and result indicators.
For Section 7, Budget, we highly recommend watching the tutorial How to Construct Your Budget in Core Projects or How to Construct Your Budget in Small Projects before you start filling it in.
And at last, Section 8 will allow you to submit your application. You will only need to submit it via this section, since we do not need paper versions any longer.
Other section in Bamos Plus. You completed all the sections of the application form, but what else do you need to know? State aid. On the dashboard, you will notice a section called State aid. This section in Bamos Plus is an informative one. You cannot edit or change any parts of it. The data in the state aid section is based on the entries you made in the application. After having selected a type of organization for each of your project partner, Bamos Plus will allocate them to the correct category of state aid relevance. This way, you will be informed whether the budget of a partner will or will not be framed under the state aid instrument of the program. If there is a need for correction in this section, we will need to do this together during the contracting phase of the project.
Contact and bank information. This section provides the contact details of the lead partner, also called the project contact, all project partners and associated organizations, as well as the project's bank account, for example, for the payment of the preparation costs and any further payment during implementation.
Document Center. In this section, you will upload the partner declarations for all your project partners, including the lead partner. The template for the partner declaration is available on our program website in the Gateway for Applicants. Every project partner will download, fill out, and sign a partner declaration. Partners can sign the document by hand or with an advanced or qualified electronic signature. Hand-signed declarations will have to be sent to the lead partner in a scanned version. Partner declarations signed with an electronic signature can either be uploaded in their original format, for example as ASIS or EDOC documents, or accompanied by a validation sheet. All documents will be uploaded in digital form only. We do not need any paper version.
We want to draw your attention to a few important facts about these two sections. Both sections, Contact and Bank Information and Document Center, will only become visible and editable for you after submission of the application, but they must be submitted by the same deadline. This means that you need to reserve sufficient time before the deadline and after submitting your application to fill out and submit the contact and bank information and to upload the partner declarations to the Document Center. We advise you to plan the day of submission of your application carefully and ahead of the deadline to have enough time to do so.
Messaging Center. The Messaging Center is the main communication channel between the MAJS and approved projects. Please note that the Messaging Center will be activated for approved projects only.
Getting help. There are three main ways to get technical assistance with Bamos Plus. The first one is the welcome screen, which appears after each login. Please read it carefully, as we will inform here about any kind of bugs, guidance, or planned downtime for maintenance. In case you need general technical guidance on Bamos Plus, please check out bamoswiki.eu. For individual requests concerning technical problems, please always contact us via the email address helpdesk@bamos.eu. Please note that the helpdesk will not be able to answer any requests via phone.
When to submit. Now that you know everything about Bamos Plus, you probably want to know when to submit all the data. The deadline for the submission of your application, the contact and bank information, and the partner declarations in the Document Center is 26 January 2023, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, Central European Time for small projects, and the 14th of March 2023, also at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, for core projects. We advise you to consider the following steps when submitting your application and the attachments. First, try not to wait with the submission until the last days of the call. Our servers might get very busy and we cannot guarantee a smooth submission in case the traffic gets too high. Second, reserve sufficient time after the submission of the application for preparing and submitting the contact and bank information section, as well as for uploading the partner declarations to the Document Center. Congratulations! you have submitted your application for the second call of Interreg Baltic Sea Region.
What happens afterwards? After you submitted the application form, the contact and bank information, and the partner declarations, we will check whether your application is complete and correct. This is called the admissibility check. If needed, we might get back to you to clarify issues. Then we will assess the quality of the applications. This is called the assessment. We base our assessment only on the information provided in the application. You can find the assessment criteria in the program manual, Chapter D for core projects and Chapter E for small projects. The last step is the selection of the applications by the monitoring committee.
Finally, the selection of the applications by the monitoring committee is planned in April for small projects and in June for core projects. However, please note that the timing for the selection is indicative and can be subject to changes.
Good luck and stay tuned.